For the purpose of this tutorial, we're assuming you only have one fan and carbon filter in your setup. There are three different types of setups that apply to every single situation, and we're gonna teach you all three versions. Timestamps are in the description, so please skip to the version that fits your needs. The first setup is the most common and is for internal temperatures higher than 78 degrees. This setup has you hanging your vent system on the top of the inside of your tent using a hanging pole. Understand that a complete setup consists of a carbon filter connected to an inline fan connected to a duct that is going through a vent on the top of your tent. Based on where your vent is, you want to choose where to hang your fan and carbon filter. Depending on how you place it, it's entirely possible to have no duct at all and connect your inline fan straight into a tent vent. Hot air rises, and what happens in this setup is hot air is being fanned out through the top of your tent. Cool air will be sucked in from an open vent on the bottom of your tent. You want to put your dust filter on the outside of your carbon filter so it catches all the dust trying to go in. The first thing you want to do is place a hanging pole parallel to the outside pole that you're hanging your system on. Slide the hanging pole as close to the other. Next, we will be hanging up the straps for your carbon filter. Hold the buckle just like this so you can see all three slots facing you and the strap is going from behind. Pull the strap all the way down and loop it back up, ensuring there is no twists. Now push that end of the strap behind the back of the outside pole you're hanging from, and when you have enough pushed in, pull it from above and over the top hanging pole as well. Then take the end of the strap and put it through the center slot of the buckle and pull it out about 3 inches. Then pull it up and into the top slot and pull it from behind. Once it's in, pull on the bottom of the strap to make sure it's secure. You could tighten the strap by holding the buckle secure and pulling hard on the loose end of the strap. Tighten it enough so that your carbon filter will fit in loosely, but not too loose. Now, do the same thing with the second strap and carefully place the carbon filter inside the two belts. Next, you want to hang your inline fan right next to your carbon filter, and we'll be using rope clip hangers. The first thing you want to do is pull out enough slack on the hangers so you have about 3 feet of line. Take a clip without the pulley attached and push it behind the back of the pole you're hanging from, up, above, and over the second hanging pole, and let the clip drape down. Do the same exact thing for the second hanger and even the levels. Now, depending on your inline fan, you may have a mounting piece that needs to be attached. It's in this gap that you're going to slide the two clips through. Make sure you're hanging your fan up in the direction where the arrow is pointing away from the carbon filter and pointing towards the vent. This just means that air is blowing out of your tent. Hold the inline fan with one hand, make sure the clip goes through that slot, and clip the clip to the clip that's attached to the pulley. Do this with the second clip, and now you could let your inline fan hang. Raise the inline fan by pulling the loose rope ends until your fan is level with your carbon filter. Once it's connected, you could lift the whole system up even more to be as high as possible. You could further seal the connection with aluminum tape if you have it. Next, drop one end of the duct through the top vent. Attach this end to the open end of the fan, and again, you can reinforce this with some tape. Now organize all your cords and plug your fan in. If you have a probe, place it near where your plants would be, and now open up a vent that's as close as possible to the floor, and that's where the cooler air will get sucked in. The last step is to tighten up all of the other vents in your tent, and that's all for this setup. The two other ways of setting up airflow is for tents that are cooler than 78 degrees. The only difference is whether you're placing this setup inside your tent or outside your tent. Both setups have the carbon filter on the floor with the inline fan stacked on top like a totem pole, and it's either blowing or sucking air out of your tent. If you have a small grow tent with limited space, you want to place your fan outside of your tent. First, place your dust filter on the inside of your carbon filter. You just roll it up like a pole, stick it in the center, and put your hand on the inside to spread it out. Next, stack your inline fan on top and have it so that the arrow on the fan is pointing down. Since the weight of the fan on top of the carbon filter is heavy, you don't really need to seal this part. Next, place your duct on top, and you could reinforce this with some aluminum tape if you have it. Now place this setup somewhere safe outside of your tent, on the floor, and close enough so that the other end of the duct could be connected to your lowest vent. Secure your duct to the vent by tightening the two vent drawstrings. Organize all of your cords and plug your fan in. If you have a probe, place it near where your plants would be. Now, open up a vent on the top of your tent and tighten all other vents, and now you have hot air getting sucked in from the top and cool air getting blown out from the bottom. The last setup is for temperatures cooler than 78 degrees, but with enough space to place your fan setup on the floor inside your tent. With this setup, you're placing your dust filter on the outside of your carbon filter. Then you're stacking your inline fan on top with the arrow pointing up. The weight of the fan will make sure the connection is snug, so you don't need to reinforce this part. Next, connect the duct to the other end of the fan, and you could reinforce this connection with some tape. Place your setup on the most convenient location on the floor inside your tent, and then connect the other end of the duct to the closest vent. Secure the duct by tightening the vent's drawstrings and organize all your cords and plug your fan in. If you have a probe, place it near where your plants would be. Now open up a vent on the top of your tent and tighten all other vents. And now you have hot air getting sucked in and cool air getting blown out.